Hello, welcome again. We are solving some questions of production engineering or manufacturing science. The topic is metal casting. Question number hold of 50 cm into 25 cm into 15 cm. Each area of the gate is 5 cm square. The filling time for the given design is option A 21.86 seconds, option B 43.71 seconds, option C 35.12 second, option D 34.01 second. So this is your mold and having dimension 50 into 25 into 15, and this is 15 centimeter, this is 12 centimeter, this area is 5 centimeters. 12 centimeter is height of screw and 15 centimeter is total height. So here now velocity at the exit of the screw, as this is top grating, so it means the bottom of the screw is at the top of the mold. So velocity at the exit of screw is just you can get by 2 ht. So ht is your 15 centimeters, and in CGS unit the g is 981, and velocity is your 2 gh. So it is 171.6 centimeter per second, and volume of the mold is given as 15 into 25 into 15. That is volume of mold, and cross section area of the gate is 5 centimeter square. So time for filling the casting is volume by cross section area. So 50 into 25 into 15 divided by 171.6 divided by 5. So that comes to the 21.86. So answer is option A. Answer to question number 6 is option A, 21.86. Time for filling the mold is 21.86. Next, bottom design for a mold of 50 cm into 25 cm into 15 cm is shown in figure below. The cross sectional area of the gate is 5 cm square. The filling time for the given design is, so this is your mold, and this is 15 cm, this is 12 cm, this is 5 cm square, this is 15 cm. Okay. Same dimension. So options are 21.86 and option B 14.24, option C 43.71, option D 34.17. So here, so this is the side view, and this at any instant the height of the liquid in the mold is h, and the height of the liquid in the pouring basin is from the down screw, from the bottom of the screw is ht. So then the velocity at t will be net effective head is ht minus h. So some velocity will be from this and some velocity from this. So net velocity will be root 2 g ht minus h. Okay. So at t the velocity will be this. Okay. So now suppose at that instant there is small change in this height, that is dh. Okay. And area of mold is am. So the change in volume in the mold is am into dh. Am is cross section area of mold, and dh is increase in height of mold. Okay. And this this is increase in volume of mold, and this increase in volume of mold is due to AG, is due to this the volume of the liquid entering at section 3. So that volume is AG into VG. AG is cross section area of this gate, and VG is velocity at the gate, and time dt, the dh head increases. Okay. So these two are equal. So now from 1 and 2, from 1 and 2, we can put dh vg as root 2 g ht minus h root h, and this this comes out as ag by am and dt. So at t is equal to 0, h is 0. At t is equal to 0, initially there is no liquid in it, so at t is equal to 0, h is 0, and at the filling time TF H is equal to HN. Okay, so integrating it will be 1 by root 2G, integration HM to 0 DH root HT minus H, AG by AM root TF by TF to 0 DT. So TF comes out as if we integrate it, we can integrate it like that, that we can assume HT minus H as X, then DX will be equal to DH, and then we can perform integration and put the limit. Okay, so the result of integration is and after putting the limit is 2 root HT minus HT minus HT. Okay, so now we can put the value of AM as 15 to 25 and AG as 5, so TF comes out as and HT as 15. Okay, so because this height is 15, so answer will be 43.71 seconds. So this is just the double of that from the top getting the time comes out as 21.86, and from the bottom getting it comes out as 43.71 seconds. So we can use that method also. We can find out the velocity at the top of the section and time at the top of the section, and then we can double the time. So that is the 43.71 is the answer. So answer to question number 7 is C. Next, in a sand casting operation, the total liquid head is maintained constant such that it is equal to mold height. The time taken to fill the mold with a top gate is TA. If the same mold is filled with a bottom gate, then the time taken is TB. Ignore the time required to fill runner and frictional effect. Assume atmospheric pressure at the top molten metal surfaces. The relation between TA and TB is option A, TA is equal to root 2 TB. Option B, it should be TB. Option B, TB is equal to 2TA. Option B, option C, TB is equal to TA by root 2. And option D, TB is equal to 2 root 2 TA. So, as we have seen in the last question, that TB comes out as 2TA from the for the bottom gating, if the time is TB, and for the top gating, if time is TA, then it comes out as 2TA. So answer is option B. So answer to question number 8 is B.